Hello, people. I guess I'm never good at these intros, but everyone says that you're supposed to be all enthusiastic and be like, hey, what's up, everybody, or whatever. It's like, fuck it, I ain't that fucking enthusiastic. You won't get that shit when you watch mine. It'll just be me being me. All right, so we're finally having a nice warm day, as you can see. It's super windy, 70 degrees, and you can't already tell, I am about to do the breaks or whatever. This video is sponsored by Coca-Cola. I'm just kidding. Yeah, right. Sponsorships. I guess I'll even hit 500. But anyways, oh god, that is loud. Just playing some Pandora radio. Sponsored by Pandora. Alright, so there they are. I just I let the car sit outside for about 30 minutes or so. It's super windy, 70 degrees, so you know, these things just chilled quickly. But here they are, replacing them with these ceramic pads. I think the ones that I currently have on there are like Wagner, but the O'Reilly's here didn't have any of them. Here had a set, and this is the only set that they had on hand, so I took these. I mean, ceramic, it's all right. Then I got a caliper toolkit to press it, compress it back down. There's my little $10 ratchet set, and a torque wrench, and also, what do you call it, jack stand. So I guess I'll pick this up as soon as I get this off for this car. Oh, man, you gotta remember to take these plastic caps off. And so I'm going to loosen these, and then I'm going to jack the car up. Okay, guys, so I've gotten the lug nuts, or whatever these things are here. Sorry, not that good at this stuff, but I've got them loosened. This one feels like it needs a little bit more, but some of these were really tight and some didn't have any issues. I didn't have any issues getting them off, but those are done. And whenever you're putting your jack on these cars, there's the little groove right there. If yours has little teeth like mine, make sure that your car's body frame sits in between those teeth, keeps it from slipping. Alright, now that I've got the car jacked up, another thing you might want are jack stands. I don't have any. The store, well, I forgot to ask if they had any, but you know, got the car lifted up. Well, the wheel was spinning, maybe it dropped a little bit. But there it is. And then another thing that people say, that whenever you're here to, you know, like grab it and check it and see if there's any wiggle room between all of that stuff and this stuff, but there is like none. The only thing that wiggles is the wheel. If you can see right in there. Just because I loosened the lugs on it. So I'll get the wheel off and then we'll go from there. Alright, so now that the wheel's off, here it is. Here's what mine looks like. As you can see, it's relatively clean. I think while I'm in here I might clean, but I mean, I still have to clean the entire car, so we'll see. Maybe I can do this like another day or something, but you know, there is like no play in my setup. I mean, it is just stiff as can be. So yeah, stiff as hell, so that's good. Not a lot of rust. I don't have a wire brush, or my dad couldn't find it, so he did give me some wool to, you know, clean off some of this dust, or, you know, but overall, you know, everything here looks to be pretty good. I mean, there is like no play in any of this. Even with the wheel on, it was stiff as hell. So I know that thing over there usually fails. Stiff as can be, so that is a good sign. Oh, and another thing, when you're doing this, don't use a cheap-ass toolkit. I just found out not the hard way, but here's mine. I need a 13 millimeter for the bolt, and as you can tell, it stripped it. So, it's a piece of shit. So, I had to go over to my dad's and borrow a Craftsman, all Craftsman tools, and one of these 13 points or something, he said. So, let's see how that goes. I think it's this way. And if you can see, it is this bottom bolt here, because this here is going to lift up. So if you do the top one and you push it down, it might put some strain on your brake line. I don't really want to do that. So it's connected down here, so I'm just going to lift the caliper up, take stress off of it and whatnot. So, let's see how this works. And it's not even gripping it. So, I don't know if I stripped the bolt with it, but... Oh man, that isn't even working either. I don't get it, my 13 fit. Oh, it's a 12. Well, alright, so I just stripped a 13 for nothing. Alright, so I got it. There's thread lock on here, so it made it like extremely difficult to get on. Need to pick some up, but I completely forgot to get thread locks. So, once you get that up, once you get that bolt taken off that connects from here to here, this whole piece lifts up. Just like this. So there it is. And so you can see my pads appear to be fine, but I bought these pads about 3 months ago or so, maybe 2 months ago, so I'm like past the warranty or a return policy. And in case you're wondering, if you're doing the screw here, it goes down. So, yeah, I kept trying to go up, but, so that's that. And then you lift this up, as you can see, takes off stress off of the brake line hose there. So, I'll get that here taken out. Well, I can't figure out where the squeak is coming from, because here's the new pad. If you can look at it, how meaty it is. And which one is this? And here's the other pad that's it, and it is nowhere near the little bar that causes your brakes to squeak, but look at how rusty this is. It's so rusty here from all the rain that we've gotten, I'm sure, that the paint has stuck to the caliper, so I'm hoping that might be what's causing my squeaks, because here's the front side that faces right here, and then this is the back side where the pistons push on it or whatever they are. I'm sure someone will comment, I fucking hate non-car people and shit, but so as you can see, they're still good and healthy. So I mean I might just give these to a friend who, someone else might need them. And as you can see, because that's what they look like, and I'm cleaning them with some steel wool, because I don't have, my dad can't find his brush, so I'm using steel wool, trying to get the paint off that's rusted on, because here, I got it off, as you can see, and then there's the rust paint from this here. So, we'll see how that goes. And then I got this, brake grease synthetic, stops the brake squeal, I guess, is what it says. So, I'll put some of this, I think I put some on here is where it goes, really, because There's nothing really pushing down on this side, but, well, a little bit as you can tell, so I'll just put some, you know, right in these general areas. Whenever I do put mine back on, and yeah, I don't know if you can tell, but this is like sunken in from the pressure of the brakes. It has sunk into a little bit into here, or rusted away from all the rain that we've had. So we'll do that. Look at all that brake dust. It just came out. So that's where I'm at right now. I have no clue what I'm doing. I got the pads off, now I'm trying to figure out how to use this stupid ass disc brake caliper tool set that I'm guessing is supposed to push this little piston down. This right here, I cleaned it up as best as I could. It's supposed to push these down to get for the new pads to fit, but I'm not having any fucking luck with this shit, so I'll post it on the page, on the owner's page, and hopefully someone will tell me how to do it. Everyone's saying C-clamps, but I don't have any fucking C-clamps. It's like, fuck, man. Always some shit. I guess while I'm waiting for someone to reply, I'll clean this shit up. This is, like, awesome. Alright, so I didn't know how to do this. Which, you know, I'll get a ton of hate. Hey, you don't know what you're doing, take it to a shop. Everyone said it on the post. But I got one of these pushed in, as you can tell, compared to this one here. I was told that next time I should just do both, put the pad in and then do it that way. But here is the setup that it needs to be at. Because when I got this, it was, you saw, it wasn't really all put together. But other owners on the GA page helped me out, so thank you guys. Even though, you know, I don't know how to do any of this stuff, but it's definitely stuff that everyone needs to learn, you know, how to do on their own car. You know, brakes, oil, and pretty essential basic stuff. Because I took it to the shop and it was $450, but they also put these GT rotors on. And these are calipers off of a GT and the GT bracket, which is bigger than the V6 bracket, which lets you run these, the half inch or whatever bigger rotors from the GT. And then the dealership wanted $500 to do it, and that's including new calipers and new rotors. And these rotors, as you can see, are just fine. They're mint, nice and smooth. So, and then I tried cleaning in here while I was waiting for everyone to, you know, give me their 2 cents or to beat my dead dog body with a stick. But overall, everyone's been helpful, so that's good. But I think this here is pretty much shot. It's been sitting in the garage since last summer because I didn't really like this product. And I think the chemical composition has decayed because it came out all extremely thick. And as you can see, it does not look good, but whatever. It's just something to kill time while I got some help on how to do this. So, here we go. I don't know if I can show you how to get that on there, but maybe I can. But anyways, this kind of like fits in here like this with this metal piece behind, and you put that round piece on the caliper and then use this to twist it and it pushes it in. I used some clamps to hold it in place to hold this giant screw while I did that. But you know, it's pretty hard to do all this stuff by yourself, so I just did it like this. Held it like that and then twisted it. And that's it. So I'll get to the other part. Alright, and here's another part, you guys. For whenever you're doing the passenger side, you have to. The wrench here goes up this way to loosen up. On the driver's hand side, it goes down. So just thought I'd let you know that. Alright guys, here's the other side too that I did. So once you get the bolt off, or whichever bolts you take off, I took off the top one I mean the bottom one. But if you can see here, right there, this piece right here, this bolt slides out. And you want to make sure that it is lubed up good. So as you can see, mine, shit, it's like so bright, you can see it is like lubed extremely well. And that keeps your caliper moving. And you want to make sure you put that grommet, this grommet right here, back over it. And that lets your caliper do this, so, you know, lets it move freely. But that's about it for this side, so I'll splice this into it in there so that, because I forgot to do that on the other side, but you have to do that if yours are, like, extremely dry, as you saw mine were, like, extremely lubed. So, there you go. I hope this video's helpful and you guys got a good laugh out of it and whatnot, and feel proud of myself for doing it. Yours truly is growing up. Oh, it is so sweet. And I guess I'll toss her in there too. There we go. Move. Alright, just keep it on here. Alright, so here's how you use this C-clamp thing. Whatever it is. Now that everyone has told me how to use this thing, I'll show you how to do it. So there it is, both of them are in. And that's how you use this weird little clamp thing. Did you want to be in my video?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, you can go back inside. Thanks. And that's one of my little brothers, the smallest one of them all. So that's done. Now all I have to do is just put these pads in and put the grease here on the back so it doesn't stick or squeak. Oh, to everyone who's tuned in to this train wreck of a show, thank you. If you're like me, hopefully this will help you out a lot and, you know, show you how to do this on yourself, because I have no clue what I'm doing. I'm just going off of what I've read on the posts and what people on the G8 page have said. And, you know, last time I took it to the shop, like I said, $450, I think it was. So, you know, $60 and I spent $150 to rent these tools, so, you know, this will be, like, a lot cheaper, and then when you rent them, you get your money back, so, it's like $60 that I paid 3 months ago or so, all to do my brake pads. And here is the part where I put in this little cream lotion thing. Crap, I did it wrong. Wait, nope. It goes like this. It goes like this in there, so, yeah, I got it right, as you can tell. Let's make sure I follow this pattern here that is on here where the contact points are. so that it doesn't rust or, you know, make some more weird sounds while I'm trying to brake, which is, you know, extremely embarrassing, you know, having such a beautiful car and then your brakes squeaking. And then especially when like a hot chick is checking out your car and you're like, yeah, this is my sexy girl. Way better than you, stop looking. And then all of a sudden you hit the brakes because you had to stop, and all of a sudden there's a squeak. And it's like, yep. Good times. Add a little bit of this here. Just like that. That's about it. Maybe add a little bit more. I really don't know how much of this stuff you're supposed to put on there. But get a little bit more of this here, right in here. And these contact points here. It goes all the way up to there. And that's some bush playing, because you can't work on your car without playing some like really good tunes. And mine are alternative rock. Stuff that I grew up with. Looks pretty good, right? Looks almost the same. Well, this one here seems to veer off, as you can see, compared to mine. It's just right down the middle. Maybe put a little bit. I just don't know how much of this stuff I'm supposed to put on here. I think that might be enough. Should be enough, right? Looks about the same, or looks about right. So, moment of truth. I really don't know how I'll do this, but let's see here. Oh, man, maybe if I do this, do it with one hand and put it in like so. Oh, ow. All right, well, you look at that. I did it. How fucking awesome is that? Yours truly, Adrian Brody, clown of the G8 world, did something on his own. This is like historic. It's on video. Subscribe and donate to my GoFundMe account. Oh, man. And right in time for like a really good song to start playing. But yeah, check out how dirty she is. Oh, man, I love this car. Sometimes this piece of shit gives me a lot of trouble, but, you know, I mean, fuck. My timing chain goes out, the engine blows in it, it's like, fuck, I ain't trading. I'm looking to buy it. My dad's helping me find, like, an old Ford F-100 or anything that's, like, in that range that's, like, fucking old and shit that I can, learn to work on, because he'll teach me all the stuff about, you know, how to work on vehicles. So we're going to get that as like our project, or dad and son project. So that'll be cool. All I want to do is just put some big tires on it and, you know, maybe a light bar, and that's it. At least cosmetically, because if it's rusty, you know, well, as long as it's not, you know, completely rusted and there's like holes in it, but, you know, if it's colored rusty or whatnot, that's fine. So, let's see. There's that one. Here's the backside pad. And I hope this posts, because if not, I'll have to cut this into two videos for YouTube. Alright, so there's the circle there. Here's the circle here, so all the way to like, what's that, 8-8? So 1, 2, 3. So there's the B, which will be right here. So pretty much just make a circle, just smear it. Down on the mattress. Oh, steel wool. I'm pretty sure you could watch someone else do a way better job at this, or maybe like a fancy video or whatnot, but you know, if you're just the average person like me, learning, hopefully all this crap helps. I mean, I'm at like, what, 182 subscribers now? That's pretty awesome, considering that, you know, I'm never going to put any effort into like making flashy videos and whatnot. It's just going to be just like this. A real dude, or a joke of a dude doing stuff to his car. Might die, but if I die, you can watch this video and be like, oh, that's what I'm not supposed to do. I'm not supposed to do anything this dude does. But hey, I'm having fun. And it's nice to learn how to do stuff to your own car, and then you can sit back and be like, yep, I did it. And then if a hot chick is like, well, I need my brakes done. Oh, hey, I know how to do brakes. It's like, yeah. I made the mistake of saying that once. I was like, yeah, I did the brakes on my car, and that was when I took the brakes to the shop. And then she was like, so, do you have time to fix my brakes? So I'm like, you know, you better go take it to someone. I don't want to be held liable for anything. Quiet, Bella. And if you play Xbox with me, you'll hear me say quiet, Bella, a lot. Alrighty then. Let's see if I can do this. Enough! Dang cat ruining my Green Day song singing experience, listening experience. Alright, now let's see, how did this one go? I really have no clue. I mean, probably would have been helpful if I'd have known. Let me look at the old pads. So this pad sits like this in the car. At least I think it does. Shit. And this is the back side. Alright, so that's how it goes. Alright. Let's do it. Oh, I guess a good way to know is that this is the back side. So it goes like this, so it doesn't go like this or any other way, it just goes like this with the little thing here facing this way. Ugh, had a burp. Alright. Moment of truth, guys. Alright, moment of truth, my ass. I can't even fucking see what I'm doing back there. And I got some knee pads, because safety first as I stick my head in here. Alright, let's see here. There's that piece there. And that piece, so I think I might have to stop it. And so I can use both hands. Well, I got it. So it just slips in right there. If you can even see that there, it'll focus. And then right there, so this, shit, what's it hanging up on? There we go. Alright, so there's that. Oh my god. Make sure I push it in. So there we go. Pads are in, caliper is on. So on the back side it goes like this. So this little clippy thing that gives you, you know, an indication of when it's time to change your brakes faces outwards. Whew. Alright. So that's that. Now all that's left to do is just put this screw back in, which goes right there. There's that, so I'll get it tightened. Alright, so here's the end of it, you guys. Here's the torque wrench that's a little too big. Keeps hitting the damn car whenever I'm trying to torque these, as you can see. Which is like shit, man. I'm trying to get this shit here, maybe I... Oh! Well, fuck, you know, it would help if I had a fucking extender, right? I don't think you guys will get this shit watching other people do stuff on their cars, you know? You watch my show and it's like, I don't know, train wreck and a movie? Train wreck and food? Let's see here, is this the extender? Well, what do you know? Yours truly is growing up. Alright. I'm like, fuck, why is it hitting the damn fucking car? Nothing I can't, no damage since it's like a rubber handle. But, yep. Let's see here. Shit, did this just move? Which way this is supposed to be. It says lock, push it down, but it still moves. I think I already did this one here. Let's do this one. Oh, fuck, man. Might just have to have my little brother come out here and... Oh, well, there we go. There we go, 125. So there we go. What do you know? I did it. So now you know how to do your brake pads on a Pontiac G8 Holden Commodore VE. Your model 2008, 2009, I don't know what the 2010 models are and whatnot. We didn't get them, but if you're in Australia and you're watching this and you don't know what you're doing, just like me, well, now you do. So there you go, you guys. Done. I can now sit back and say, I did it myself. So there we go. Done. Now I'm going to do the other side. Now that I know how to do that other side, it'll be like super quick. So, there we go, you guys.